Hello, friends. My name is Alyssa, and I'm the science program manager at Boston Children's Museum. And I want to welcome you back to my kitchen. Today, we are going to use popular Thanksgiving food to learn how to write and decode secret messages. What Thanksgiving food do you think we'll be using? Take a guess. It's not turkey. I'll tell you. It's cranberries. And for those of you who have never seen an actual fresh cranberry before, this is what they look like. Maybe you've had cranberry juice or dried cranberries, sometimes called craisins, or cranberry sauce. But this is what a plain, fresh cranberry looks like. And this is what we're going to be using today to make our spy juice. You'll need about half a bag or 6 ounces of fresh cranberries. The other things you'll need are baking soda, water. And to write your secret messages, you'll need a lollipop stick, or if you don't have a lollipop stick, like I don't, you can take a Q-tip and cut the end off. And that will make a good pen for your spy ink. To prepare the spy juice, you're going to need grown-up help because we're going to be using the stove. Put about 3 cups of water on to boil, and then after it's boiling, dump in your 6 ounces of cranberries and let them simmer for about 15 minutes. When they're done, strain them out through a strainer and then let the juice cool. I've got my cranberry juice right here. Now, you can try it if you want. There's nothing in it that's going to hurt you, but it's not going to taste like the cranberry juice that you get at the store. That has sugar in it, or something else to sweeten it. Cranberries are very, very tart. And if you want to find out how tart, take a little sip of this cranberry juice. And the reason that we're using this and not the cranberry juice you can buy at the store is, in addition to having sugar in it, that has also been watered down, and it won't be as effective at decoding your messages. To send a secret message, you'll need to mix up some spy ink. Take some baking soda and about the same amount of water. So there's about the same amount of baking soda as water. It doesn't have to be perfect. And then stir them together. And that's your spy ink. Doesn't look like anything special. To send a message, dip your lollipop stick or your cut-off Q-tip into your spy ink and then carefully write it on a piece of plain white paper. And then let it dry. I got a note from my friend Jack the other day, but it doesn't look like there's anything written on the paper. This is where the spy juice comes in. I've poured my spy juice into a spray bottle. But if you don't have a spray bottle, you can just lightly flick some juice onto your paper and carefully spread it around, or you can even pour some juice into a container like this one and then carefully dip your message into it. I'm going to use my spy juice to see if I can read it. It says, "Happy Thanksgiving." Well, thanks, Jack. Well, I hope you enjoyed today's Thanksgiving-themed science activity. Keep checking back with us on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube for more fun STEAM activities that you can try at home. Thanks for joining me in my kitchen today, and I'll see you next time.